I am Francisco Guillén. I am head of the Preventive Medicine Department at Navarra University Clinic, and I am also professor of Preventive Medicine and Public Health. And I am from Navarra, Spain.
Excellent. In Spain, you've been speaking to kinship carers about the problems that have been in their families because of the drug issues of the parents of children. So what have they told you?
Well, they have many problems, sometimes health problems, because they are elderly people. When they just want to rest, they have this problem or they have. Sometimes they also have psychological problem because of the stress of carrying the children, and sometimes if one or their son or their daughter has the drug problem, sometimes they feel guilty, and also sometimes they don't know how to deal with the bureaucratic process, get funding. An additional problem for them is that in the late stage of their life, their pension is very low, and they have to provide care for these boys and girls, or sometimes even to get psychological assistance. Mm-hmm. So they have many problems, and they are forgotten group in the population. They are not a very big group, so they feel like isolated. Also, there are some support for the authorities. There should be more to help them.
Yeah. What is it that you've been doing over the last year to try and change that situation that you found when you spoke to the carers?
Well, we have done several things. First, we prepare a resource guide that can be used for kinship care, because many are isolated, there are no association, or if there is some association that for them to join, sometimes they don't know. And I was thinking, what would happen to my mother and my dad, my father is 84 years old, and my mother 80. My wife had an accident, and say we have to take care of three girls.
Yeah.
So we have prepared a guide to that can be used to get resources, not only legal or psychological aid, or how can you get people that support children when they are in the school, there are NGOs, there are a lot of resources, but they don't know how to get, no? Because sometimes these are very old people.
Yeah.
No? Also, we have prepared a legal guide that can be used for them, because there are several ways that you can have the custody of your grandchildren or nephews, and you have to know all the issues. And now we are preparing a DVD that can be used by one hand to sensibilize the general population and the politicians about the need to have policies that support this group of population. And also, this DVD will be used also to help to train the technicians, like social worker, healthcare, etc.
Okay. Well, that sounds really interesting. And my final question, really, I think to you, Francisco, is having spent 2 years thinking about these issues, and you've also conducted the literature review that has really been important to the project. Are there any messages that you think that politicians at either a national or a European level should be thinking about, or should be told about?
Yeah, I think that this problem is going to increase, because immigration, sometimes you have people who moved from one place to another, and they leave the children with their grandparents, or other parents who go into jail, or legal problems, or mental problems. Probably the main issue is drugs.
Yeah.
But there are other issues. or because of divorce, maybe with parents, and there are problems with the custody. So this is going to increase, and I think the politicians should think to have a European, maybe directive or no policy on those issues, and that should be applied for or to all the nation.
All the European nations.
Mm-hmm. That could help.
Yeah, I agree. I think that's something that tells us as a continent that we have these issues.
Because we are not probably we don't know the extension of that. But now, for example, in my region, 60% of the children in foster care is in kids care. Yeah. So that is going to be increasing. Also, it's better for the children to grow with the family because they have an history that to be in a flat with some social worker or.
So I think that's another important lesson and message, isn't it? Is that actually being in kinship care, despite the terrible circumstances, is better than.
Yes, I think it's better that to be in an orphanage or an apartment.
Yeah.
I remember this when these histories of Deacon Oliver Twist, and that's from the 19th century. So I think it's better to support this kind of policy. It's better for the children, for the families, and also for the society.
Thank you.